क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर पेज 136 एक्सरसाइज 3.2 क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर Now listen carefully. If you remember, I told you yesterday, CX and CY, common factor. How will you obtain U if you change the scale X minus? How will you obtain U if we change the scale X minus A upon CX and V Y minus B upon CY? CX and CY are basically the common factors with which you divide, as we used to do in correlation and regression. Further, I discuss if you remember, if you multiply, then the common factor will become 1 upon. Means if you multiply with 5, then the common factor is 1 by 5. If you multiply with 2, then the common factor is
1 by 5.
Multiplying by 5 means dividing by 1 by 5. Multiplying with 2 means dividing by 1 by 5. Are you okay with this? Look at question. For the following information is obtained to study the relation between the carpet area in a house and its monthly rent in a city. Now, carpet area X. All of you see the values of X. Kailash, what is the common factor in X?
5.
Yes, can you see all the values are divisible by 5? 55, 60, 75, 80, 100, 120, 140. All are divisible by 5. On the left side mentioned CX is equal to 5. Common factor in X is 5. Look at monthly rent rupees by 18,000, 19,000 up to 50,000. So, Amrut, what is the common factor? 1,000, three zeros are there everywhere. Means what is the common factor in Y? 1,000. So, write down on the left side, CY equals to 1,000. Raise your hand who did not understand this. All the values of X are divisible by 5. So, common factor in X is 5. All the values of Y are divisible by 1000, so common factor in Y is 1000. Obtain the regression line of final line Y on X directly given. And then estimate the monthly rent. GK?
So, monthly rent will be
Y cap. And then estimate the monthly rent market as Y cap of a house having carpet area of 110 square meters. Sumana? Carpet area of 110 square meters. Are you doing the homework on your own? X, X bar means mean of X. X, so what will you do with this? 110. Are you doing the homeworks on your own or copying it from the illustration? Then you don't understand what you do with this, I will give you the question. In the final equation, what we get, we will put it in the value of X. So it's not X bar, it's only X. Market is X, everyone. Okay, whatever equation we get in X, we will substitute 100 and N. Here we don't have to denote X and Y. Directly first we will find X bar and
Y bar.
So write down the values of X and Y, obtain X bar and Y bar. All are obtained X bar and Y bar. Now listen carefully, this we have done in correlation chapter also, test is also taken. Me, how will we obtain U? Correct, dear end of, just you have to be careful about one thing. What is the common factor in X? So what you subtract should be?
Multiple
of 5. Is 90 already a multiple of 5 or not? So you can directly do X minus 90 divided by 5 because X is already a multiple of 5. Below X bar and Y bar, everyone write down CX is equal to 5. What is the common factor in X with which we have divided? 5. Any confusion in this? Once again, what is the common factor in X with which we have divided? 5. So CX is equal to
5.
Are you all clear with it? Same way. Gina, how will we obtain V?
V is equal
to
2600
directly 26,000 upon 1000. Correlation chapter also I asked you this thing and told you practice it properly. So much of homework was also given. First of all, you remain absent a lot in my class. Yesterday, were you present? Why? Where out? Why you did not tell me day before yesterday?
I also
you absent so much a lot and you are never able to answer my questions. That shows how you are practicing the homeworks. This we have done in correlation, still you are not able to answer me right now. Shubhadra, how will you obtain V? Y minus 26,000 divided by 1,000. V will be equal to Y minus 26,000 divided by 1,000. I'll ask you again in the next question. Do you understand this? From Y we have to subtract 26,000. Is 26,000 already a multiple of 1,000?
Yes.
So directly we can subtract it. Below X bar and Y bar, what is CY you will mention?
1,000.
What is the common factor in Y? 1,000. Did everyone understand this? Now this calculations we have studied in correlation. So Swara, tell me the values of U. Yes, all of you be attentive. How would you do it? 55 minus 90 divided by 5. Minus 7.
Minus
6. 60 minus 90 divided by 5. Minus 6.
Minus 3.
75 minus 90 divided by 5. Minus 3. 80 minus 90 divided by 5 minus 2. 100 minus 90 divided by 5 2. 120 minus 90 divided by 5, that is 6. Then 140 minus 90 divided by 5, that is 10. Total comes to 0. Because you are subtracting x bar itself, which is 90, so total comes to
0.
Any confusion in this? Raise your hand who did not understand the values of U. Karnik, tell me the values of V.
Minus 8.
Yes, 18,000 minus 26,000 divided by 1,000 minus 8.
Minus 7.
19,000 minus 26,000 divided by 1,000 minus 7.
Minus 6.
20,000 minus 26,000 divided by 1,000 minus 6. 20,000 minus 26,000 divided by 1,000, again minus 6. 25,000 minus 26,000 divided by 1,000 minus 1. 30,000 minus 26,000 divided by 1,000, 4. And 50,000 minus 26,000 divided by 1,000 is 24. Total again comes to 0 because we are subtracting by bar itself. Any confusion so far? Now, are we asked coefficient of determination?
No.
Yes or no?
No.
So what workings we will make?
U
square and
U.
When would you also find V square?
When
coefficient of determination is asked. Are you all clear with it? Now, U square. Are you all clear with it? What is the total?
238.
238? U squared, so 7 squared 49, 6 squared 36, up to 10 squared 100. Any confusions? Then, Lavina, UV. U into V, minus 7 into minus 8, 56. Minus 6 into minus 7, 42, and so on, up to 10 into 24, 240. Did everyone understand this? Now, the pattern of solving the question remains same. Right on, regression line of y on x is given by y cap equals to a plus bx. Did everyone complete the workings? Raise your hand, I'm still writing it. Now understand how the things will change here, where b equals to byx, which will be equal to bvu into cy upon cx. Yesterday did we change the scale? So we simply said byx is equal to bvu. Today have we changed the scale?
Yes.
Now, regression coefficient is independent of change of origin but not of
scale.
So, if we have changed the scale, we have to cancel its effect. How do you cancel its effect? Into Cy upon?
Cx.
Did everyone understand this? Now, BVU is N sigma UV. Stop talking in between. What is the problem? Then why are you talking in between? How much did you score in stats test in correlation?
31.
31 only. And how much did you score? Anand, how much did you score in statistics test? 33. Why not 40 out of 40? You are genius, so you must be able to score. Now again, if I find people talking in between, you both will be out of the class, okay? Yes, n sigma uv minus sigma u into sigma v upon n sigma u square minus sigma u whole square into. Now what is cy? 1000. Cy is 1000 and upon cx is 5. So into 1000 divided by 5. Is everyone clear with this? Cy upon Cx is important point in this question. All are clear with that? Correlation, we did not do that because correlation, we studied the property. It is independent of change of origin as well as
scale.
Means scale does not affect. But here it is not independent of scale, scale affects. So to cancel its effect, we do 1000 by 5. Now, n is 7. Sigma uv we have obtained as 390. Minus sigma u is 0 and sigma v is also 0 upon n is 7, sigma u square is 238 minus sigma u is 0 whole square into 200. 1000 divided by 5 means into 200. Any confusion? Now, is it 2730 minus 0 upon
1666
minus 0 into 200. Now directly do it. Don't first divide. Write the answer in two decimals and multiply 200. Your answer will come wrong. Directly do in calculator 2730. Divide by 1666 into 200.
327.73.
If you divide, round it off, and then multiply, you'll get 328. That'll be wrong. So, final answer will be rounded off in two decimals. Therefore, directly do the calculation. 2730 upon 1666 into 200. Is everyone clear with this? Any conditions? Now further. A equals to y bar minus dx bar. Okay, A is equal to y bar minus dx bar. Anyone still writing up till B? Raise your hand. All are completed. Now, what is y bar?
26,000.
All of you can see this. Minus b, 327.73 into x bar, 90. Got it, everyone? Now, 26,000 minus. What is 327.73 into 90?
9495.7.
So minus 3495.7. A can be negative. Minus 3495.7. Any conclusions? Now we will write the line again. Therefore, regression line of y on x is y cap equals to a plus bx. So y cap equals to a, we will write minus 3495.7, plus in b we will write 327.73x. Did you understand this portion? Any confusions? Now what do we have to substitute in x? 108n. So if x equals 210, then y cap is minus 3495.7 plus 327.73 into 110 minus 3495.7 plus, what is 327.73 into 110?
36050.3.
And remaining is
32554.6.
Means if the carpet area is 110 square meters, the monthly rent will be estimate of rupees 32,554.6. Did you understand this, everyone? Is this portion of changing the scale clear? How does it affect your answer? All of you? And on this, if the carpet area is 110 square meter, then the estimate of monthly rent will be rupees 32554.6. Look at page 152, section B. Page 152, section D. This I am doing on the board, then one short question you will try on your own. So look at it. Section D of exercise 3, question number 12. If BYX equals to 0.8, write down BYX equals to 0.8. Be careful. You are not given BVU. And you have to find BYX. You are given with
BYX.
You are given with BYX and they say find the value of BVU for the following U and V. Look at the first sub question. U equals to X minus 105 and V equals to Y minus 90. Are you changing the scale?
No.
You are changing only the origin. So BYX will be equal to BVU.
Yes.
Means BVU will be 0.8 itself. So write down BVU will be equal to BYX will be equal to 0.8. Any confusion in this? Yes, your answer is not clear. You are not changing the scale, means you are neither dividing nor multiplying. So as we did yesterday, BYX and BVU values will come same. They will change only if you divide or you multiply. Any confusions? Look at the second. U equals to X minus 1400 divided by 100. V equals to Y minus 750 divided by 50. Now be attentive here. Dividing by 100. So what is the common factor in x?
100.
Cx is equal to 100. Dividing by 50. What is the common factor in y? Cy equals to 50. Right now. Now we will apply that formula. Byx is equal to BVu into Cy upon Cx. But what is this 0.8? It is the value of
BYX.
So on the left side write 0.8. Able to understand this? BVU is what we have to find. Into what is CY? upon CX. Able to understand this? Now tell me, here 100 is divided. If you bring on the opposite side, multiply. Here 50 is multiplied. If you bring on the opposite side, divided. So can I say BVU is equal to 0.8 into 100 divided by 50? That is 1.6. Is everyone clear with this? And question number 3. Raise your hand who is not clear with this. All are clear with it? See, third sub question, U is equal to 10 into x minus 4.6 and V is equal to y minus 75. Now, first of all, multiply it by 10, so what is CX? And what is CY?
1.
No common factor means you write it as 1. No common factor means you will write the common factor as 1. Is everyone clear with this? Now, Shivam, next step.
BYX
is equal to BVU
into CX upon CY.
By CX upon CY, CY upon CX. You always apply the formula CY upon CX only. Is there any multiplication in B? If there is multiplication in both, you still apply CY by CX, you automatically get CX by CY. Because a common factor you will take 1 upon. But you always apply this formula only. Okay, in exams, will not give marks if you write CX by CY. But you will automatically get CX by CY. After this question, I will explain. Anyone having any doubt in this? BYX equals to BVU into CY upon CX. One should substitute the values. What is BYX? It is given in the beginning 0.8. It's common for all the three questions. Further? Now, BV used to be found then into 1 upon 1 by 10. Sit down. Renuka, 1 upon 1 upon 10.
1 into 10.
Yes, 10. Reciprocal of 1 by 10 is 10. Any confusion in this? 1 divided by 1 by 10 means multiplied by 10. Any confusion up till here? This is the next step. Yes, 10 on the other side will get divided. So what is BVU equals to 0.08? Any confusion in this? Now see what I was telling you, understand it. Suppose U was equal to 10 into X minus 4.6 and V was 5 into Y minus 75. Then what is common factor of X? What is common factor of Y? Now you will do BYX equals to BVU into CY upon CX only. But when you do CY upon CX, what is CY upon what is CX? So can I say 1 by 5 into 10 by 1? Automatically what do you get? 10 divided by 5. That is CX upon CY. You will automatically get that. But you always apply the formula CY upon CX. Is everyone clear with it? Yes.
We cannot multiply 0.8 into 1 by 10.
0.8 into?
1 by 10.
I can do that. You get the same answer. Yes.